can be sunny with never a sigh. Don't need what money can buy. Birds in the tree sing their day full of song. Why shouldn't we sing along? I'm chipper all the day, happy with my lot. How do I get that way? Look at what I've got. I've got rhythm, I've got music, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? I got daisies in green pastures, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? Old man Trouble, I don't mind him, you won't find him round my door. I got starlight, I got sweet dreams, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? Who could ask for anything more? I got rhythm, I got music, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? I got daisies in green pastures, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? I got rhythm, I got music, I got rhythm, I got music, I got daisies in green pastures.
Bye. else today in society. Go for classical poetry. So to win their hearts, one must quote with ease Aeschylus and Euripides. But the poet of them all, who will start 'em simply raving, is the poet people call the Bard of Stratford-on-Avon. Brush up your Shakespeare, start quoting him now. Brush up your Shakespeare, and the women you will wow.
Just to claim a few lines from Othello, and they'll think you're a hell of a fella.
If your blonde won't respond when you flatter her, tell her what Tony told Cleopatra.
If she fights when her clothes you are mussing,
what a clothes much ado about nothing. Brush up your Shakespeare, and they'll all kowtow. With the wife of the British ambassador, try a crack out of Troilus and Cressida.
If she says she won't buy it or take it, make her take it once more as you like it.
If she says your behavior is heinous,
kick her right in the coriolanus.
Brush up your Shakespeare, and they'll all count.
Okay, this is December the... Are you ready? This is December the 6th, 1982, and we're visiting Jack and Sue and the kids, and we are now going to sing together. Ready? Okay. First she put her eyeball in her pocket, unscrewed her leg from its socket, her hair long and fair, she placed on a chair. Side by side, I could see this would be an adventure. As she carefully took out her denture, I whispered aloud as it clunked in the glass. Side by side, through all the weather, one if the sky won't be hard. And through all kinds of weather. I wish you were together instead of falling apart. I stood by the bed broken-hearted. Most of my bride had departed. I slept on the chair, cause there was more of her there. Side by side.
Richard, are you sure that you have to go right now?
Richard, on the floor. Here.
My goodness.
That's it. Most of me surprised.
It's a tough one.
Is it taping?
No, good.
So maybe he stood up at the thumb.
Now, if anybody actually ever got a hold of this tape and use it against you, you'd be in a world of trouble.
What is that? It sounds like you're just a bunch of people. 1 o'clock in the morning. It says right on the tape, man, it's 1 o'clock already, so you'll know you're drinking or
what
something.
What a party, huh?
Party!
We have an ending stronger than potatoes.
Hey, what, 20 of you? Coffee?
Here comes Richard with a mop behind him.
Down to work now.
Yeah, come on, let's finish this game so we can go home. I'll be driving like a zombie.
That's all right.
Whatever Lola wants, Lola gets. And little man, little Lola wants you. Make up your mind to have no regrets. Recline yourself, resign yourself, you're through. I always get what I aim for, and your heart and soul is what I came for. Whatever Lola wants, Lola gets. No use to fight, Don't you know you can't win? You're no exception to the rule. I'm irresistible, you fool. Give in. Give in. Give in.
There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The corn is as high as an elephant's eye, and it looks like it's climbing clear up to the sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. All the cattle are standing like statues. All the cattle are standing like statues. They don't turn their heads when they see me ride by. But a little brown maverick is winking her eye. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day.
I do not know you well, but when the music started, something drew me to your side. So many men and girls are in each other's arms. It made me think we might be similarly occupied. Shall we dance on a bright cloud of music? Shall we fly? Shall we dance? Shall we then say goodnight and mean goodbye? Or perchance, when the last little star has left the sky, Shall we still be together with our arms about each other? And shall you be my new romance? On the clear understanding that this kind of thing can happen, shall we dance? Shall we dance? Shall we dance?
When the last little star has leave the sky,
shall we still be together with our arms about each other? And shall you be my new romance? On the clear understanding that this kind of thing can happen, shall we dance? Shall we dance? Shall we dance?
Jerk. Well, anyway, what are you doing there, Jack?
I'm taping you.
Ah! He's taping me. So he got down. He got the thing down, but he wouldn't let us out till this girl did this talk. You know, and she's going on about, welcome to San Francisco, and we hope that you've enjoyed your flight, and we look forward to serving you again. And I thought, over my dead body, which is very likely. This is true, but that was it. And then they finally opened the door, and I got out, and Sue was there to open it, to welcome us. And I was honestly kind of nauseous. And there was little Wee in her uniform, you know. And then we got in the car, and we couldn't find them. We didn't get the bags. And we got into the car, and we're coming home on this real fast parkway. And my stomach's, of course, back in the airport. But Sarah starts to read me out of her geography all about the globe, about London, and the USSR. And this kid can do 5-cylinder words, Peggy. I mean, it was too much. It was just too much all at once. You understand? I love seeing the kids, but we left when it was 65 degrees, and it's just a bit nippy here. You know, I mean, well, it's cool. It is really cool. Have you? I keep telling these two that we're breaking records in Pittsburgh. Oh, yes. Janet said that she had a fire. Sue was a booger, and she called Janet tonight, unbeknownst to me. And I got Janet on the phone. I mean, I was talking to her. She said, this is the first time they've had a fire. She's had a fire. Oh, well, maybe that must be it. Oh, Peg. They were running in shorts yesterday. Yes, shorts and T-shirts. Oh, but listen, it's so neat to see these kids. Oh, Jack took us, and I saw a telephone booth with a pagoda on the top of it. And it was so neat, you know, and everything, all the stores have subtitles. All the stores have subtitles. You know, they all have the things underneath in the little figures. And I saw an Oriental typewriter. You wouldn't believe some of the things, I tell you. It's just so neat. And we went to the not the crematorium, exploratorium. The exploratorium. You know, it was on a TV. It has all these little hands-on type experience things that you learn to do, you know. And I'll tell you all about it when it's on my own nickel.
Yeah, you're running up a bill.
Yeah, Sue, go ahead. Go ahead. Jenna called, right. Yes. Yeah. Well, I just talked to her, and she says everything's hunky-nibsy. The only thing that bothered her was the first night. She went to, you see, we have the bed downstairs, I told you, by the dining room. And she said she couldn't get to sleep, and she kept hearing this tink-tink, tink-tink, tink-tink all over the house. And finally she realized what it was. It was Fanny's toenails walking around. And I said, so she, no, all over, see, you know, the carpet's on. no carpet, and she couldn't get accustomed to that, so she put her earplugs in. So she could get to sleep. But she says everything's fine. She's had the quiche and the vegetable soup and all, and she said the kids are fine. She's been taking Maul for walks and had Fanny in the yard because it's so balmy, you know. Peg, the Lord did this for me, so I wouldn't worry about those kids, you know. It's real neat. And I'm not worried. I thought I would be the whole time, and I'm not. And it's just been, Jack's been crin-crinning us to San Francisco. We went to Chinatown. We went to the... No, he didn't have to get off work. And I think Sarah only missed the one day of school when she met me at the airport. And she went to school today, and she's going tomorrow because Sue's going to take me. We're going to fly tomorrow instead of going Amtrak. Yeah, because Amtrak only gets in late at night and early in the morning. So Dad says, yeah, that's right. And besides, it's just too much of a hassle for poor Carol to come late at night. It's just not fair to her with the baby, you know. So that's the way it's going to be. We'll get there about 2:15 her time, which is neat. Leaving Carol's? We're going to leave Carol's next Sunday morning. No. Yeah, all right.
Waddly-a-cha, doodly-doo, doodly-doo. I like the rest, but what I like best is doodly-doo. Doodly-doo, to it, all you do is doodly-do it. I love it so,
but the best
doodly-doodly-do.
Never saw you look quite so pretty before. Never saw you dress quite so handsome, what's more. I could hardly wait to keep our date this lovely Easter morning. And my heart beat fast as I came through the door. For in your Easter bonnet, you'll be the grandest fellow in the Easter parade. I'll be all in clover, and when they look us over, we'll be the proudest couple in the Easter parade. On the avenue, Fifth Avenue, the photographers will snap us, and you'll find that you're in the rotogravure. Oh, I could write a sonnet about your Easter bonnet and of the guy I'm taking to the Easter parade.
Thank you. this is a man who thinks with his heart. His heart is not always wise. This is a man who stumbles and falls, but this is a man who tries. This is a man you'll forgive and forgive, and help and protect as long as you
Virginia Hardy, aloha mom, happy anniversary, happy 55th anniversary of your 21st birthday. Come visit your number three kid here in Kalua.
You know, I like that music. Who wrote it?
Tchaikovsky!
Tchaikovsky? I love Russian composers. There's Malachevsky, Rubinstein, Arensky, Yanchakovsky, Sapelnikov, Dmitriev, Cherepnik, Rezhinovsky, Godovsky, Atabuchov, Moniusko, Akimenko, Solovyev, Prokofiev, Priyamkin, Goroschenko, Zwinkler, Winkler, Bortniak, Rebekov, Kofedinsky, There's Metter Balakir of Zolotarev and Kwasinski, and Sokolov and Kopolov, Dukhelsky and Kranovsky, and Shostakovich, Boradin, Glier, and Novikovsky. There's Liadov and Karganov, Barkeyevich, Panchenko, and Dargumisky, Chervachevsky, Ryabin, Vasilenko, Stravinsky, Rimsky, Kosakov, Kuchorsky, Yangrachaninov, and Lazunov, and Cesar, Kvikalinikov, Rachmaninov, Stravinsky, Yangrachaninov, Rumshinsky, and Rachmaninov. I really ought to stop. The subject has been brought upon enough.
Stravinsky,
Rachaninov,
Rumshinsky,
Rachmaninov.
I better stop because we feel we all have undergone enough.